My father was a tailor in Leeds. As was his father and his father's father. Time was, if a man on the Avondale Road asked where he might find the finest clothes in Northern England, he was pointed towards the shop of a man named Rackham. Then the men who sell wool decide they prefer not to compete with the men who imported fine cotton, and as the men who sell wool have the ears of the men who make laws, an embargo is enacted to increase profits, and calico disappears. And my father's business that he inherited from his father and his father's father begins to wither and die. And my father suffers the compound shame of financial failure seen through the eyes of his son. He descended into drink. I'd sit beside him as a boy at the Sunday service as he shouted at the pastor, at the altar, if anyone would listen, really, at the injustice of it all. I'd put his arm over my shoulder as the insults began. Help carry him out of the church. God, the insults. At his funeral, our neighbors were kind enough to whisper them rather than call them out loud. So, I set to work, determined to rebuild what had been taken away. I was 13 years old, but I was determined. Until a man arrived at my door, claiming to hold debts belonging to my father. Debts accumulated as my father drank. Debts he claimed that now belong to me. Debts I could not possibly have hoped to repay. Debts over which this man would have seen me imprisoned. Imprisoned in a place where the debts would have been discharged only through hard labor. Hard labor at no wages. Working at, wait for it, the production of textiles.